Very good afternoon. I hope and I believe all of you are doing well, guys. Yes. Am I audible and visible? Okay. So Raj has a query ki why in iOS not showing the club? How can I join? Please don't agree or please don't get angry. What was that, Raj? So iOS में आपको नहीं दिखाएगा the membership thing. You can do it from anywhere, be it Android phone or be it laptop, and then you can use it in your iPhone. Okay, so with your ID, which is there, basically the mail ID registered on YouTube, जो आप देखते हो जिससे, उस पे you'll have to do from any device. Okay, so this is not like device specific, right? And उसके बाद, yes, this is rewatchable, भागराज, this is rewatchable, all right? So, are the night owls also here who were there in the yesterday's night owl session, the study with me session? कि अब तक सो रहे हैं, the night owls are still sleeping. What's the scene? Right, so guys, who are night owls and who have not joined us in the study with me session? So we do your study with me. That is where we study live. मतलब I am being seen on the camera, but rest of you are not. But then it is very very productive. And we do it at midnight. And yesterday we actually studied like till 2:30, 2:30 a.m., 12:30 to 2:30, absolutely. Okay. So what was that I was telling about fluconazole and voriconazole? So वो table तो यार जो वो table में values थे 0.7 और 0.21. So let me see if I can. Let me get the PDF to show you guys what was I talking about. So this table, where is that table? This one. Right, so this table which is there, the CSF serum concentration, which is 0.70 actually है, तो वो फ्लूकोनाज़ोल का है, वॉरिकोनाज़ोल का CSF serum concentration is 0.21. So I told you that it was an omen when I am making a mistake कि कुछ तो बड़ा न्यूज़ आने वाला है, and your news was INICT postponement after that. So this is what I made a error here, that it is not वॉरिकोनाज़ोल more than फ्लूकोनाज़ोल. Fluconazole has the maximum CSF penetration, right? So fluconazole is the one which is used in your cryptococcal meningitis. So remember, it is fluconazole more than voriconazole, not voriconazole more than fluconazole. All right. So ye tha, is that clear, Midhun? Right. So please make a correction there. All right. Please make a correction there. Okay. So no. I actually slept even after 2:30 a.m. it was done. I actually slept. I was not getting sleep till 5 a.m. in the morning. I was awake till 5 a.m. So I slept only at 5 a.m. and then I woke up at 9 a.m. So that is when I woke up. Right. Chalo. Abhi agar ho gaya hai sawal jawab. So let's start with the session. And antifungals. I'll first tell you the table. There are some very very important questions. So quickly we'll be running through them. I hope all of you have revised the session that we had yesterday for antifungals. So let's first see this table, which is the choice of drugs for your systemic mycosis. Everywhere if you see systemic mycosis, candida ho gaya, crypto, histo, coccidioblasto, har jagah aapka amphotericin B, amphotericin B, amphotericin B, amphotericin B. Everywhere you have amphotericin B, which is there. The two conditions where you do not see amphotericin B at all is this one and this one. Okay, so this is where you do not see amphotericin B. Now in your, so that is why remember that amphotericin B is not the drug of choice in these two conditions. That is your paracoccidioidomycosis and your chromomycosis. Okay, remember this one. Baki har jagah aap amphotericin B de sakte ho. Right? So these two are the ones, paracoccidio and chromomycosis, where your amphotericin B is not the first choice. Amphotericin B is not the first choice. Here, paracoccidio, at least you can give amphotericin B as the second choice. Chromomycosis mein to amphotericin B mention hi nahi hai. Chromomycosis mein. Alright? So this is the point that I wanted to highlight. Second point, when you have candidiasis. So fluconazole, yesterday we saw, it's a single oral dose treatment for vulvovaginal candidiasis. Nystatin is available and swallow. You know, swish and swallow wala treatment for oropharyngeal candidiasis. Clotrimazole bhi hai, jo locally hum apply kar sakte hain. Amphotericin B and even your voriconazole. Okay, your voriconazole as well. For cryptococcus, you have amphotericin B with or without 5-fluocytosine. Remember, amphotericin B increases the permeability. So you give with or without. This 5-fluocytosine is given orally. Amphotericin B is given as an injection. Fluconazole is the second choice for cryptococcus. Alright. Now, aapka posaconazole is the one that you see that it has efficacy in mucor mycosis as well. Not for mucor per se, but for rhizopus. Okay, but for rhizopus. So, rhizopus, mucor mycosis, mein rhizopus, mucor rhapsidia aata hai. So, which is the azole which has mucor mycosis mein efficacy? That is posaconazole. Okay, that is your posaconazole. Baki, aap dekh lo, aapka itraconazole bahut sare jagah pe hai. Itraconazole. Histoplasmosis, blastomycosis, paracoccidioidomycosis and even your chromomycosis, right? Sporotrichosis mein first drug amphotericin B and the second one is your itraconazole. So if not amphotericin B, then give itraconazole. These are the drugs that we are using most often. Other points to be noted, aspergillosis mein you have voriconazole, right? So remember this extra point as well. Voriconazole, aspergillosis A and V, and you also have caspofungin, right? You have caspofungin as well. Jahan humne padha tha, caspo aspergillus mein hota hai, mucor mein posa hai, okay? And chromomycosis mein, you have your terbinafine. Chromomycosis, you have your terbinafine, which can be given. First is itraconazole. Coming to the next important table here, so oral absorption, amphotericin B ka nahi hai, caspofungin ka nahi hai. These are given as injections only. And out of this, which is given as a loading dose? Caspofungin requires your loading dose. Which echinocandin does not require loading dose? That is your micafungin, right? That's your micafungin. Next one, which is given IV, which is not given IV, the drugs that we saw in the table. So, all of these can be given IV. Your 5-fluocytosine is not given IV. It is not given IV. It is only oral. So, remember cryptococcus mein amphotericin B injection, 5-fluocytosine is oral. Elimination route, aap sabka dekhoge, hepatic sab mein hai. Flucytosine and fluconazole. Flu wala, urine flow, renal elimination hai. Theek hai? It's renal elimination. Then you have your resistance, isme nahi hai, 5-fluocytosine mein resistance bahut jaldi aata hai, isiliye we give with other drugs. So that's why, that's the other reason it is administered with other drugs. None of them is nephrotoxic except your amphotericin B. Okay, so amphotericin B is the one which is nephrotoxic. Anemia, bone marrow suppression, 5-fluocytosine does, it's like an anti-cancer drug. Amphotericin B, AM, remember anemia, that can also cause anemia. Rest of them do not cause anemia. Okay. Baki overall toxicity, kiski sabse zyada toxicity hai? Amphotericin B ki sabse zyada toxicity hai. Theek hai, so these are the points that I want you to remember from this table. What are the points? That fluconazole and flucytosine, they have renal elimination. Flucytosine is only given as an oral drug. Nephrotoxicity is seen with amphotericin B. Anemia is seen with amphotericin B. And your 5-fluocytosine as well. These cause anemia. So remember these points about these drugs, right? Now let's go to the MCQs. Okay, let us go to the MCQs. The only azole which has shown efficacy in mucor mycosis. M ke saath kaun sa dekha humne? M ke saath it is P. That is your posaconazole. Okay, that's your posaconazole. That is what is your posaconazole. ऑल राइट गाइज, आई फॉरगॉट टू टेल यू द टुडे इज यू नो द टाइम टेबल की और कौन से सेशंस है. लाइक एवरी डे वी विल हैव 5 PM फ्री लाइव क्लास ऑन अन अकेडमी ऐप वेयर इट इज योर इमेज बेस्ड क्वेश्चन. सो वो आपको जो फोटो भेजा है उसमें रेडियो डरमैट मैंशनड है, बट एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट वी विल डू योर ऑफ्थाल्मोलॉजी के थोड़े इमेजेस एंड वी विल डू योर ऑफ्थाल और मे बी सम रेडियोलॉजी डरमैट है तो आई ट्राई एंड पुट सम रेडियोलॉजी इंटरेस्टिंग इमेजेस एज वेल एंड इफ पॉसिबल डरमैट. ऑफ्थाल का जो हमको पार्क 3 टेस्ट रिवाइज करना है, इफ पॉसिबल आई इंक्लूड सम इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एज वेल एंड सम अदर इंपॉर्टेंट इमेजेस. ठीक है, सो इट्स गॉन बी मिक्सड बैग. बेसिकली इट्स अ मिक्सड बैग इमेज बेस्ड क्वेश्चन, इट वुड बी अ मिक्स बैग ऑफ एवरीथिंग. सो ओनली अजॉलस पोसोकोनाजॉल. हाँ, दूसरा याद रखना कि 10 बजे आज जो हमारा YouTube सेशन होता है वो आज नहीं है. वी डोंट हैव एनी YouTube सेशन टुडे एंड टुमारो बीइंग अ संडे राइट यू विल नॉट हैव एनी सेशन टुमारो. वील बी बैक विथ मंडे एंड वंस योर दिस टाइम टेबल इज ओवर विच वी आर फॉलोइंग ऑन द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप. नाउ दैट द एग्जाम इज पोस्टपोन्ड अगेन विल मेक अनदर टाइम टेबल एंड आई ट्राई एंड सी वट एक्स्ट्रा एंड न्यू थिंग वी कैन डू सो दैट एवरीवन इज ऑन ट्रैक. ओके राइट, इंट्राऑक्युलर लेंस इंक्लूड करना है स्वाति. आई ट्राई माई बेस्ट टू डू दैट. कैडावरिक इमेजेस प्लानिंग टू डू क्विज जैसा सो दैट ऑल ऑफ यू रिवाइज कैडावरिक इमेजेस एंड कम. आई ट्राई एंड पुट सम इमेजेस ऑफ कैडावरिक इमेजेस टूडे. तो रिवाइज करके आना, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन सेशंस ऑन दैट. डरमैट में STI. ओके, सो STI के इमेजेस हम कर लेंगे, फ्यू इमेजेस ऑफ STI. ओके, लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट वन. सो दिस इज वॉट वी हैड डिस्कस्ड जब हम पढ़ रहे थे आधी रात में कल. टर्बिनाफिन इज फंगीसाइडल, इज दिस अ ट्रू स्टेटमेंट और दिस इज अ फॉल्स स्टेटमेंट. सो लेट मी पुट दिस क्वेश्चन एज अदर क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट. मार्क द फंगीसाइडल ड्रग्स. यू हैव एम्फोटेरिसिन बी, यू हैव ग्रीसियोफल्विन, यू हैव योर कीटोकोनाजॉल, यू हैव फ्लूकोनाजॉल, यू हैव योर एंड टर्बिनाफिन. Okay, these are the drugs that you have. Tell me, multiple options correct hai, which of these are fungicidal? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Which of these are fungicidal drugs? Okay, so that is where the confusion arises. Many of us think that, तो एम्फोटेरिसिन बी द फंगीसाइडल है ही है बिकॉज इट क्रिएट्स द पोर्स, इट्स अ पॉलीईन, इट क्रिएट्स अ पोर, एवरीथिंग गोज आउट, इट इज फंगीसाइडल. बट रिमेंबर दैट टर्बिनाफिन इज ऑल्सो फंगीसाइडल. दिस इज अ ट्रू स्टेटमेंट. वाई टर्बिनाफिन इज साइडल एंड ग्रीसियोफल्विन, कीटोकोनाजॉल, फ्लूकोनाजॉल आर स्टैटिक इज बिकॉज एम्फोटेरिसिन बी क्रिएट्स द पोर्स सो द फंगस डाइज. टर्बिनाफिन, वट डज इट एक्ट, हाउ डज टर्बिनाफिन एक्ट? By inhibiting your squalene epoxidase, right? It inhibits your squalene epoxidase. So squalene accumulates and squalene is toxic to the fungus and it kills the fungus. So that is why it is fungicidal, it is killing. While your griseofulvin, what is the mechanism of action? It acts on your mitotic spindles. Azoles inhibit your ergosterol synthesis. Audible and visible guys, so CPR successful though it took a long time. Yes, so seems like mere laptop ke aakhri din aa gaye hai. The laptop has become old, bas last few days it seems time and again CPR dena padta hai. And you know, this is, I think, this if you apply to your studies as well, the charger was connected. I was under the impression ki haan, charger connected hai, charge ho raha hai. But only when it, you know, got conked off, then I realized ki sab lagaya tha, but button hi switch on karna bhool gaye the. So this is applicable to our studies as well. You know, aap padh rahe ho, books hai, saath mein, you have connected yourself to the books, lagaya hai, cable lagaya hai. बट जब तक दिमाग की बत्ती द बटन चालू नहीं करोगे तब तक वो फ्लो नहीं होने वाला है राइट. एंड हाउ डू यू पुट ऑन दैट दिमाग का बत्ती? इज बाय स्टॉप थिंकिंग अबाउट एनीथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग एल्स. दैट इज हाउ यू पुट ऑन द बटन. नहीं तो लगेगा कि हाँ कनेक्टेड तो है, बट देन यू विल रियलाइज थोड़ी देर बाद कि अरे कुछ दिमाग में गया ही नहीं. सो इसीलिए दिमाग की बत्ती चालू करके पढ़ना. सो अदरवाइज इट्स नो पॉइंट. इवन इफ द बुक इज देयर, द चार्जर इज देयर, यू हैव कनेक्टेड एज वेल, बट इफ द बत्ती इज ऑफ, इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू गेट चार्ज. एब्सोल्युटली राइट. सो हाँ, टर्बिना फिन पे हम थे. तो टर्बिना फिन इज फंगीसाइडल. ओके, टर्बिनाफिन इज फंगीसाइडल. दैट मीन्स इट अक्यूमुलेट्स क्वेलीन एंड स्क्वेलीन इज टॉक्सिक टू द फंगस. ओके, स्क्वेलीन इज टॉक्सिक टू द फंगस, दैट इज वाई इट इज फंगीसाइडल. सो एम्फोटेरिसिन बी, टर्बिनाफिन आर साइडल. सो करेक्टेड इन योर नोट्स. आई सॉ इन वन ऑफ द नोट्स इट वॉज मैंशन स्टैटिक, इसीलिए आई हैड टू रीचेक. एंड दिस वॉज अ पॉइंट दैट आई लर्न न्यू इन द नाइट आउट सेशन वेन आई वॉज स्टडिंग, कि ये साइडल है. बिकॉज अदरवाइज आई वॉज अंडर द इम्प्रेशन दैट इट इज स्टैटिक, लाइक मेनी ऑफ यू. इवन आई वॉज अंडर द इम्प्रेशन दैट इट इज स्टैटिक. राइट. चलो नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट वन. टर्बिनाफिन इज यूज्ड ओरली एंड टॉपिकली, व्हाइल ब्यूटेनाफिन इज यूज्ड ओनली टॉपिकली. दिस अगेन इज अ ट्रू स्टेटमेंट. ओके, दिस इज अ ट्रू स्टेटमेंट. सो टर्बिनाफिन वी कैन यूज ओरली ऑल्सो एंड टॉपिकली ऑल्सो, व्हाइल ब्यूटेनाफिन इज यूज्ड ओनली टॉपिकली. तो ये उल्टा है, नाम का उल्टा है. जो टर्बिनाफिन है एक्चुअली वो सिर्फ टॉपिकल नहीं है, वो टॉपिकल एंड ओरल है. जो ब्यूटेनाफीन है वो नाम के जैसा नहीं है, बोथ नहीं है, वो सिर्फ टॉपिकल है. ओके, दैट इज टॉपिकल ओनली. सो रिमेंबर, टी इज बी एंड बी इज टी, दैट इज टर्बिनाफिन इज बोथ एंड बी इज टी, दैट इज ब्यूटेनाफिन इज टॉपिकल. सो टी इज फॉर बी एंड बी इज फॉर टी, दैट इज व्हाट वी हैव टू रिमेंबर. राइट. चलो नेक्स्ट वन. हाँ, अभी बाकी क्वेश्चंस पे आते हैं. ये भी हमने कल डिस्कस किया था, बच्चों को बताया था कल नाइट आउट सेशन में व्हेन आई स्टडीड. अभी नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन से स्टार्ट करते हैं. विच एंटी फंगल एजेंट इज मोस्ट लाइकली टू कॉज रीनल इनसफिशियंसी. देखा, नेफ्रोटॉक्सिक कौन सा है, विच इज नेफ्रोटॉक्सिक, दैट इज योर एम्फोटेरिसिन बी. इट कैन कॉज नेफ्रोटॉक्सिसिटी विद हाइपोकैलीमिया और हाइपरकैलीमिया. इट कॉजेज योर आरटीए टाइप 1. टाइप 1 आरटीए हैज हाइपोकैलीमिया, सो इट कॉजेज टाइप 1 आरटीए विद hypokalemia. So that is your amphotericin B. So do not give it with other drugs which are nephrotoxic by themselves. Next one. A 55-year-old woman presents to the hospital with shortness of breath, fever and malaise. She has a history of breast cancer, receiving chemotherapy, chest X-ray pneumonia, cultures positive for aspergillus. What is the appropriate choice for treatment? Aspergillus A ka ulta karo V, that is your voriconazole, right? The drug of choice is voriconazole. Aspergillus, acute angle, and it is septate. Branching at acute angle and septate, that is aspergillus. All right? Voriconazole, absolutely. Next one. Which antifungal agent should be avoided in patients with evidence of ventricular function? So, this is a extra edge question. This is a extra edge question. Let's see who gets this right. Which antifungal agent should be avoided in patients with evidence of ventricular dysfunction? Absolutely, that is your itraconazole. That is your itraconazole. So itraconazole comes with a black box warning ki agar ventricular dysfunction mein hai to nahi dena. It can cause worsening. It is itraconazole. Okay, it is your itraconazole, not to be given in your ventricular dysfunction. So when you write ventricular dysfunction, TRI, that is ITR, itraconazole is the one which is avoided. It is itraconazole which is avoided. Next, a 56-year-old woman with diabetes complains of thickening of the nail of right big toe and a change in color. The podiatrist diagnoses the patient with onychomycosis of the toenails. What is the most appropriate choice for treating this patient? What is the most appropriate choice for treating this infection? Nail infection, keratin ke wahan jata hai. Appropriate choice is terbinafine. Greasyofalvin abhi bahut use nahi karte hai. It is terbinafine which is used for fingernails and for toenails. Kitne time ke liye dena padta hai? It is given for 6 weeks and 12 weeks, which is still better than the other drugs. So, terbinafine, topical, oral, both can be used. Terbinafine, mechanism of action, squalene epoxidase inhibitor, it's a sidal drug, right? It's a sidal drug. Next, A 44-year-old man presents to clinic with fever, chills, headache, shortness of breath, exploring caves about 5 weeks ago, diagnosed with acute pulmonary histoplasmosis. What is the most appropriate choice for treating this patient or infection? Jab caves ka history aata hai, so remember, think of your histoplasmosis, acute pulmonary histoplasmosis. और इसमें क्या रहता है, वॉट इज द मोस्ट अप्रोप्रिएट चॉइस फॉर हिस्टोप्लाज्मोसिस? यू डू नॉट हैव एम्फोटेरिसिन बी इन द ऑप्शन. अदरवाइज बहुत सारे सिस्टमिक के लिए एम्फोटेरिसिन बी है, बट इट इज टॉक्सिक, यू हैव टू गिव आईवी. सो वॉट इज द ड्रग? इट्राकोनाजोल. फॉर मेनी ऑफ योर डायमॉर्फिक फंगाई, इट इज ईदर एम्फोटेरिसिन बी और इट्राकोनाजोल, राइट? इट्स ईदर एम्फोटेरिसिन बी और इट्राकोनाजोल. एम्फोटेरिसिन बी एज अ फर्स्ट चॉइस ड्रग, इट इज नॉट यूज्ड इन paracoccidioidomycosis, chromomycosis, that is basically your dermatophytes में, it is not effective. Dermatophytes में नहीं use करते हैं, paracoccidioidomycosis में second line कर सकते हैं, dermatophytes में it is not effective. Anyone knows histoplasmosis का एक classical radiologically क्या होता है, histoplasma का classical radiology में? It has a calcification which is your target calcification. So if they tell you target calcification is seen, then it is your histoplasma. Remember, target calcification, right? Next one. A 32-year-old HIV positive woman admitted to the hospital with severe confusion and dizziness, non-adherent with HIV medications, diagnosed with meningitis, cryptococcus neoformis. What is the most appropriate choice for treating the infection in this patient? Absolutely, that is your amphotericin B plus flucytosine. Okay, amphotericin B plus flucytosine. Your flucytosine is not given alone because there are high chances of resistance. Why is it given with amphotericin B? Because amphotericin B increases the permeability. Cytosine permeates, permeability badhata hai. It is amphotericin B plus flucytosine. If not this, or first this induction wala treatment is done, then what is the second line drug, or what is the alternative drug that we can use? That is your fluconazole, the azole with maximum CNS penetration. Right, the azole with maximum CNS penetration, that is your fluconazole. Flucytosine alone is not given because resistance develops. Okay, right. Next one, 22-year-old woman reports a cottage cheese-like vaginal discharge and slight dysuria for 1 week, diagnosed with candidiasis. She requests as short a course of treatment as possible due to her busy schedule. Which antifungal is the best choice? So the patient has vulvovaginal candidiasis and the patient wants a short course of treatment. Then what will we give? We will give your oral fluconazole, because for vulvovaginal, a single oral dose is enough. Okay, a single oral dose. So fluconazole, oral fluconazole is what we will give. Candida mein humne kya dekha tha appearance? Recent aapka OBGY session mein. What appearance does it have? That is your sheesh kebab appearance, right? Candy and sheesh kebab. Going out and having sheesh kebab and candy. And which one had cotton ball appearance? Which one had cotton ball appearance? That was your actinomyces, right? That was your actinomyces, which has cotton ball. Candida is sheesh kebab, right? Next one. Which drug is relatively free of drug-drug interactions? Which drug is relatively free of drug-drug interactions? So your azoles, they are metabolized by cytochrome P, so not free of interactions. Mica fungin, your echinocandins, not metabolized by cytochrome P. That is where you have your no interactions, mica fungin. Okay, and mica fungin is the one we said which does not require a loading dose. Rest of the echinocandins, they require your loading dose. Next one, which drug works by creating pores or channels in the fungal cell membrane? So it is creating pores. Which is the drug which works by creating pores or channels? AMPO, right? So that is what we said. AMPO, tericin B, AMPO creates the pores. Which are the other group, other drugs in this group? Your polyene group mein aur kaun sa aata hai? Nystatin is also like amphotericin B and hermicin. Nystatin and hermicin. Where do we use nystatin? Oropharyngeal candidiasis. Okay, swallow karke le sakte hain. Right? Next wala. Which drug requires a loading dose? Abhi already humne dekh liya. Which drug requires a loading dose out of these? So caspofungin is the one which requires a loading dose. Your echinocandins except your mycafungin is the one which requires a loading dose. So echinocandin except your mycafungin, they require a loading dose, right? What was the mechanism of action of tavaborol? Tavaborol, T for T, it is tRNA synthesis inhibition, tRNA inhibition. That is how it inhibits your protein synthesis. So it acts on which organelle? It acts on ribosomes. Okay, it acts on ribosomes. Your tolneftate, the other drug tolneftate with T, tolneftate tod deta hai, matlab hyphal distortion karta hai. Tolneftate does hyphal distortion, right? Very good. So you guys remember everything. I'm so glad to see that. Next one, very easy one I would say. These are the type of questions that we should be focusing on for the easy ones, but the lengthy ones. 12-year-old girl, ALL hai, bone marrow transplant, she develops fever, blood culture candida, and the patient develops hypertension, fever, rigors, and the serum creatinine is increased. So if you look at the last two lines, you'll be able to get the answer. So do not waste too much time in reading the first few lines. Pehle last do line padho, nahi answer aa raha hai, fir baaki ka padho. Serum creatinine is increased. So this is your amphotericin B, right? This is your amphotericin B because it is nephrotoxic, right? It is nephrotoxic. Very correct. Amphotericin B, fever and chills. That is your chills, shaking and fever, bake. So it is your shake and bake syndrome, shake and bake, right? In addition to fungi, amphotericin B is active against the following pathogen. It is active against which of the following? Fungal or amphotericin B or ka use karte hai? Leishmania, right? That's your leishmania. Kala azar, that is your leishmania, visceral leishmaniasis. Liposomal amphotericin B is used. Liposomal amphotericin B, right? The distinctive feature of terbinafine is, so there are, you know, quite a few questions on antifungals, alag alag resources I have got for you, because I personally believe the more MCQs you solve, the more you remember. So I am a very, very staunch believer in that, solving the MCQs. The distinctive feature of terbinafine is, it is highly effective in histoplasmosis, can be used topically as well as orally for dermatophyte. Inhibits mucor and aspergillus as well. Applied intravaginally, it cures both candida as well as trichomonas. Very correct. Ye humne dekha, it can be used topically as well as orally. So T for B and B for T. Terbinafine both and butenafine only topically. It is not effective in histoplasma. It does not inhibit mucor. It is active against candida but not against trichomonas. So remember, it is the drug of choice for your nail fungal nail infection. The following drugs are effective in systemic mycosis except, again on the similar line you have this question. The following drugs are effective in systemic: itraconazole, ketoconazole, fluconazole. All of these are your azoles. They are used in systemic mycosis. Terbinafine is not effective in systemic mycosis. It is either dermatophytes or your superficial candida infections. Okay? Terbinafine, absolutely. Itraconazole to dekha na ke bahut sare jagah pe dimorphic fungi mein, histo, coccidio, paracoccidio, bahut sare jagah pe itraconazole is the drug. Ye humne dekh chuke hain already. This one. The polyene antibiotics act by which of the following? The polyene antibiotics act by B. Binding to ergosterol and creating micropores. Polyene create pores, right? So they are cidal. They are cidal. Inhibiting fungal cytochrome P450. These are your azole group of drugs. Or dusra apka fungal DNA synthesis is your flucytosine, anti-metabolite, antifungal flucytosine. Microtubules move like a grease. That is your greasyofulvin, right? That's your greasyofulvin. Our sporotrix mein drug of choice, amphotericin B bhi hai, itraconazole bhi hai. Dono de sakte ho. First line humne amphotericin B dekha. Amphotericin B is not effective. It is not effective in the following fungal disease. Amphotericin B is not effective in the following fungal disease. Dermatophytosis. Okay, so Vinayak, we call polyenes as antifungal antibiotics. They are like antifungal antibiotics. Very correct, Anjana. So remember, DNA synthesis mein aapka flucytosine ke alawa cyclopyrox bhi hai. Cyclo, cyclic molecule, DNA, pyrimidine, to wo hai. Dermatophytes mein, they are not effective. Absolutely. Amphotericin not effective in dermatophytes. बाकी ऑलमोस्ट हर जगह यूज करते हैं. मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉक्सिसिटी ऑफ एम्फोटेरिसिन बी इज नेफ्रो न्यूरो हेपेटो बोन मैरो. दैट इज योर नेफ्रोटॉक्सिसिटी. ओके, दैट्स योर नेफ्रोटॉक्सिसिटी. दैट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस नेफ्रोटॉक्सिसिटी डिक्रीजेस विथ योर लाइपोसोमल एम्फोटेरिसिन बी. इट इज लेस विथ लाइपोसोमल एम्फोटेरिसिन बी, राइट? So, question on the newer lipid formulations of amphotericin B differ from the conventional formulation in the following respects, except kahan differ nahi karte hain. Very correct. They are more efficacious. They are not more efficacious. That is not true about liposomal. The liposomal ones do have decreased side effects, be it your acute reaction is milder, nephrotoxicity kam hai, anemia bhi kam hai. Why is the side effect less with your liposomal amphotericin B? Because they have decreased tissue binding. So they cause less effects on the tissue. So nephrotoxicity bhi kam hai. They are more expensive. Okay, they are more expensive. They are not more efficacious, but they decrease the side effects of amphotericin B, right? So remember, they are not more efficacious. It's just that the side effects is less. Next, indicate the antifungal antibiotic which is used intravenously for systemic mycosis. Intravenously, that is injection, as only given as injection is your amphotericin B. It is not given orally, right? It is not given orally. Greasyofulvin, on the other hand, is oral only. No topical, no IV for greasyofulvin. Oral, the absorption increases with the fatty meals. The absorption increases with fatty meals. The drug of choice for monilial diarrhea is. What is the drug of choice for monilial diarrhea? Monilial diarrhea मतलब basically your candida वाला diarrhea, oropharyngeal candidiasis आगे diarrhea में, it is your nystatin. Okay, nystatin is the drug of choice. Next, which antifungal agent is effective in both dermatophytosis as well as systemic mycosis? Which antifungal agent is effective in both dermatophytosis as well as systemic mycosis? Dono mein effective hai. Okay, guys, I'll share this PDF after the session on the Telegram group so that you know you get to revise the MCQs as well. Which antifungal agent is effective in both dermatophytosis as well as systemic? So I can see a lot of mixed answers here. Options rule out karo. Amphotericin B has no activity against dermatophytes. Against systemic, yes, but not against dermatophytes. Greaseofalvin only in the keratin rich areas like your terbinafine as well. It is not effective in systemic. Clotrimazole topically, it has effect in candida. Ketoconazole is the one which is effective in both ketoconazole, both the dermatophytosis as well as systemic mycosis. But because of a lot of side effects with ketoconazole, now we do not use ketoconazole a lot. So it is available as shampoo also. Shampoo mein rehta hai. Aap isko orally bhi le sakte ho. So ketoconazole is available oral also and basically topical also, but not IV. Azoles jo IV nahi dete humne dekha tha. Ek was the mnemonic. Ek hi root hai oral wala. That is itraconazole and ketoconazole. They are not given IV, right? Okay. Fluconazole differs from ketoconazole in that it is not active by oral route. It is a more potent inhibitor of drug metabolism. Not effective in cryptococcal meningitis. It is unlikely to produce anti-androgenic side effects. Ketotopical also. That is what we said. Shampoo wagera topical aata hai. Yes, your azoles are effective against dermatophytes. Very correct. So, fluconazole differs from ketoconazole in that it is unlikely to produce anti-androgenic effects which are seen with ketoconazole and not with fluconazole. Fluconazole, it is not active by oral route? No, it is active by oral route. It has a high oral absorption, oral bioavailability is high. And it is independent of the gastric pH. Independent of the gastric pH. Ketoconazole is a potent inhibitor of drug metabolism. It inhibits your cytochrome P. All azoles do, but ketoconazole does the maximum. And that is why you have to be careful with other drugs which cause long QT syndrome, wagera. So that we have to keep in mind. It is effective in cryptococcal meningitis. It has your maximum CNS penetration in the azoles. And the correct answer becomes your D. Okay. Next, interaction between these drug and cell membrane components can result in the formation of pores lined by hydrophilic groups present in the drug molecule. What will be the answer to this? So the question is on pores, forming the pores. Remember polyene wala. Polyene is amphotericin B, nystatin and hermicin. So that the answer is nystatin. Caspofungin is your echinocandin. Candin inhibits your beta-glucan synthesis. It acts by beta-glucan. Flucytosine. Cytosine is your DNA pe act karne wala. Grease, moving like grease is your mitotic spindle. This is forming the pores. Terbinafine S, that is your squalene epoxidase, is inhibited, right? So the answer is nystatin. It is nystatin, not flucytosine, guys. Not flucytosine. Next one. So this patient should be treated immediately with a 28-year-old man living on the East Coast was transferred by his employer to California for several months. On his return, he complains of having influenza-like symptoms with fever and cough. He also has red tender nodules on his shins. His physician suspects that these symptoms are due to coccidioidomycosis contracted during the stay in California. So this patient should be treated immediately with which of the following? So this is a bit of a tricky question that I would say. This is not a straightforward one. So we need to actually know about the management of coccidioidomycosis. The answer here is none of these drugs. Why is it none of these? Because remember that ye jo aapke coccidioido ke mild symptoms hai, influenza jaise, ye khud hi theek ho jate hai. It does not need treatment till the time it is limited. Your red tender nodules, that is what is this? This is your erythema nodosum. Okay, you will see erythema nodosum. These are actually a good sign. These are your good prognostic factor. So when the patient has this limited with a good prognostic feature, erythema nodosum, it does not need any antifungal treatment. Automatically, it will you know, spontaneously resolve. So the answer is none of these drug. But then, if the question is what is the drug of choice if this patient is suffering from persistent lung lesions, ab wo spread ho gaya lungs mein, ya disseminated disease hai, then the answer will become your amphotericin B. Okay, then the answer will become amphotericin B. When it is persistent or disseminated, then give amphotericin B. Otherwise, it is none of these. Okay, otherwise it is none of these. Is that clear with everyone, guys? All right. So answer then will be amphotericin. Mild cases mein, no need of antifungal to be given. Right. Which drug is least likely to be effective in the treatment of esophageal candidiasis if it is used by the oral route? Which drug is least likely to be effective in the treatment of esophageal candidiasis if it is used by the oral route? Now, think very logically. So these are all mixed bag questions I'm telling you from whatever books I could, you know, put my hands on. Sabse maine mixed bag questions lai hai so that you get to solve many questions on this topic. Clotrimazole, candida mein effective hai. Greasiofulvin, we said it's only against dermatophytes and nothing else. Greasiofulvin sirf dermatophyte hai aur kuch nahi hai. Ketoconazole hai toh itraconazole bhi hai. Azoles will be effective in your candida. Nystatin, we said, is the drug of choice for oropharyngeal candida, diarrhea and all of that. It is greasiofulvin. Remember, greasiofulvin is only dermatophytes. Keratin-rich areas. It is keratin-rich areas, so only dermatophytes. So the answer becomes greasiofulvin. Okay, the answer becomes greasiofulvin. Ho gaye questions, khatam ho gaye. So this was about the antifungal drugs. Mixed bag of questions is what I wanted to show you all, and I hope all of you are now much more confident with the topic of your antifungals. So ye table jo hai wo yaad rakhna ki har jagah aapka basically everywhere you have your amphotericin B, which is the first choice, voriconazole in aspergillus, paracoccidioido, itra, chromomycosis itra. Amphotericin B is not effective in dermatophytes. Amphotericin B is not effective in dermatophytes. In dermatophytes, the drug which is given both oral and topical, it can be your terbinafine, it can be azoles as well. Only topical is butenafine, is only topical. And you have greasiofulvin, which is only, greasiofulvin is only orally given drug. Okay, greasiofulvin is only orally given drug. If I have the annotated PDF, ye jo bhi maine gandi writing mein bhi likha hai, if you guys want, I'll share this with annotations on the group. Please try and read it today itself. If you do it later, you will not even understand my handwriting, whatever you have written. So best hai ki aaj hi likh lena aur apne notes isme add kar lena. So that you will at least be able to remember, if not read, that what did we discuss. So you can make your notes on this. So I'll be sharing the PDF on the group after this session. Theek hai? Okay, everyone. Thank you so much for joining in. Let's meet at 5 p.m. I'll share the link in this video as well in the comments and also in the Telegram group. It's a free live class. If you're joining for the first time, Dr. Nikita is the code. Some very, very important image-based questions is what we'll be seeing. Some very, very important image-based questions. All right. Theek hai. Thank you so much, everyone. Goodbye. Take care. And keep studying. Keep